This is going to be the second video about solving rational equations, and I just want to do one more example to make sure that we're comfortable with it. So here I've got the equation x plus 2 over 2x plus 3 equals x minus 1 over 3x plus 1 over x. So the first step is to find the excluded values, the values that x cannot have because it would turn one of the denominators into 0. So looking at that first fraction, it has a denominator of 2x plus 3. And if I set that equal to 0, I'll find out what would make the x into a 0. What would make the denominator into a 0? So I'll subtract 3 from both sides of the equation. It's going to give me 2x equals negative 3. And then when I divide both sides by 2, I find out that x equals negative 3 halves, which means if I made x into negative 3 halves, the denominator of that first fraction would be 0. So that means x cannot equal negative 3 halves. It's one of my excluded values. Looking at the next fraction, that has a denominator of 3x. So obviously, if x was 0, the denominator would equal 0. So x cannot equal 0. And then looking at the third fraction, the denominator is x. So if x was 0 once again, the denominator would be 0. So my excluded values are negative 3 halves and 0. Now the second step is to see if there's anything I can factor, but there isn't. I can't factor any of these denominators. So now I have to find the lowest common denominator. Well, let's see. If I look at the right side of the equation, I've got one denominator, which is 3x, and one denominator, which is x. And I know I could turn an x into a 3x by multiplication. I would multiply it by 3. So that means that for those two fractions, the lowest common denominator is going to be 3x. Looking at the 2x plus 3 on the left and the 3x, I can't turn either one of those into the other one by multiplying. So I'm going to have to get my lowest common denominator by multiplying these two. In other words, my lowest common denominator, my LCD, is going to be 3x times 2x plus 3. That's what I'm going to multiply each of these fractions by in order to get rid of my denominators. Okay, so let's do that. I'm going to have 3x times 2x plus 3 times my fraction, which was x plus 2, over 2x plus 3. And that's going to equal my lowest common denominator, 3x times 2x plus 3, times my fraction, which was x minus 1 over 3x. And then I want to multiply the lowest common denominator by my last fraction. So that's going to be 3x times 2x plus 3, times the fraction, which is 1, over x. Okay, let's see if we can clean this up. So looking at the first bit, the left side, I've got a denominator that's 2x plus 3, and in the numerator, one of the things I'm multiplying is 2x plus 3, so I can cross those out. And then I can multiply this 3x times x plus 2. So I'm going to distribute 3x across the x plus 2. 3x times x is 3x squared, and 3x times 2 is 6x. On the right side of the equation, the first thing I come to is a fraction with a denominator of 3x, and that's being multiplied, that whole fraction is being multiplied by 3x, so I can cancel out the 3x. And then I've got 2x plus 3 times x minus 1, which means I have to FOIL those two together. So 2x times x is going to give me 2x squared. 2x times negative 1 is negative 2x. 3 times x is positive 3x, and then 3 times negative 1 is negative 3. For the last part of this, I've got an x as the denominator, and it's being multiplied by 3x, so I can cancel out my x's, and then I'm going to have 3 times 2x plus 3 times 1. Well, I don't have to worry about the times 1. So 3 times 2x plus 3, distributing that, I'm going to get 6x plus 9. Okay, a lot of numbers here. So let's clean up each side of the equation. Well, the first side of the equation, the left side, can't be cleaned up, in fact. That's just 3x squared plus 6x. But let's try to collect some like terms on the right side of the equation. I've only got one thing with an x squared, so I'll have a 2x squared. Then I've got, let's see, negative 2x plus 3x is a positive x. And I've got a 6x, so x plus 6x will give me plus 7x. And then I've got negative 3 plus 6, excuse me, negative 3 plus 9, which gives me 6. And now I'll get everything on the left over to the left side of the equation. I'll just have a 0 on the right. Let's see what I get. So 3x squared is on the left. I've got a 2x squared on the right, so I want to subtract 2x squared from both sides. 3x squared minus 2x squared is just going to be x squared. Then I've got 6x on the left and 7x on the right. So subtracting 7x from both sides, 6x minus 7x is negative x. And I've got a 6 on the left, on the right, so I have to subtract 6 from both sides, minus 6. So I've got x squared minus x minus 6 equals 0. I want to factor that. So I'll start out with, I've got these two binomials. They'll both have an x in them. And then I've got negative 6 and a negative x in the middle. So one of my terms is going to be positive. One of my numbers at the end is going to be positive. One's going to be negative. And if I use a 3 and a 2, 3 times 2 is 6, I'll be able to get what I want. I want, since the middle term is negative, I want it to be a negative 3. I want to use that negative for the bigger of the two numbers, 3 and 2. And I'll have x plus 2 times x minus 3 equals 0. So solving this for x, I'm going to find I would get x plus 2 equals 0, which means x equals negative 2. And I've got this x minus 3 equals 0, so that would mean x would equal positive 3. Let's take a look. Well, neither of those numbers is an excluded value. My excluded values were negative 3 halves and 0. So that means both of these answers should work, which is possible. Let me fix that 3. So my answers should be x equals negative 2 and x equals 3. And again, what you want to do, the safest thing would be to plug each of those answers, negative 2 and 3, into the original equation everywhere where you had an x and make sure the equation balances. Okay? So that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.